Okay, so notice there's two explicit rules. I don't know why this chart was different. I like probably copied the charts right now that they each of those text book. I don't know why this chart was different than the other one. Obviously one of them has to be when it starts at zero and one of them is when it starts at one. Okay. If this first one is when it starts at zero, so this is when when initial starts at zero. So when initial position and these formulas look really familiar. This one here is the exact formula we were using last week, right? Except that instead of a sub 1, they just wrote a. So a sub 1 to the n minus 1, times r to the n minus 1. Okay? This is similar to yesterday in the fact that we have f of n minus 1, instead of adding the difference, we're multiplying by the ratio. Okay? So you know that anytime you have a recursive, if you go into this function notation, it's always f of n minus 1. Okay? And then remember, you still have to list whether it's f of 0 or f of 1 equals the first term. Alright, so these should go quick. We've only got 4 of them to do. And then we'll have some work at stamping them. We haven't stamped yet. The first thing you want to do is you want to actually test to make sure Mrs. Ballard didn't trick you and give you an arithmetic one when it should be geometric, right? So we're going to practice that geometric, that ratio. So I'm going to do the second one divided by the first one. So 6 divided by 3, which is 2. Okay. And I'm going to keep going. I'm going to try it 3 times to make sure it is in fact geometric. Okay. Then I'm going to go 12 divided by 6, which is 2 again. Then we're going to go 24 divided by 12, which is. So we're really confident once we're putting out that it is geometric. I use the same notation I used yesterday, explicit EF. Okay. And we're going to write an in function notation, so we write f of n equals. Alright, what is my first term? 3. And then the ratio we got was what? 2. Am I starting at 0 or am I starting at 1? 0. Because when I started, if I go back and look here, if I start at 0, I only use n. If I start at 1, I use n minus 1. Okay, so I'm going to just put an n. The way to remember which one, that first term, really, you need that exponent to go to 0. Okay, because you want this here to be the first term, right? So as long as it's been 0 here, then it goes to 0. If it was 1 there, then you need it. That's why we have to subtract the 1 off of it. So we get this thing to go away. Okay? Alright. Look at the recursive. So I have to list where my first term is in this fancy notation. So what's that first one? F of 1, 0 over 1. 0, and what is it equal? F of 0 equals 3. Alright, and then I'm going to write F of n equals, I have to do my ratio first. So what's my ratio? 2. My ratio is 2. And then I multiply by f of n minus 1. That's it, done. Okay, so now if you want to go with this. Remember, please excuse my ear, Aunt Sally. Exponents go before multiplication. Okay, so that. Alright, let's do this one. A little bit uglier, we got some fractions going on. Okay. So I'm gonna suggest we do something a little bit different to test. ratios. As long as the terms are consecutive, I can test the ratio, right? There's no rule that says I have to do this. Couldn't I come down here and test these two? Okay, so let's go from the back until we get three pairs. Okay? So we're going to do 25 divided by 5, and what do I get? 5. Okay, and then I'm going to do this pair here. 5 divided by 1, and I get 5. All right. And then this one here, I'd much rather do 1 and 1 fifth than 1 fifth. Right? So now I'm going to do this pairing here, and I get 1 divided by 1 fifth. So we can flip and multiply the denominator, and that also equals 5. Okay, so we're really confident for GMS. All right, so we're going to go explicit first. How do I start with the explicit? F of n equals. Good. All right. My first thing I need is my first term. What's my first term? Okay, over 25, what's the ratio next? 5. And then what exponent do I use? N minus 1 because I'm starting at 1, and I want this exponent with my first term to be 0. Okay? All right. Recursive. F of what to start with? F of 1 equals 1 over 25. And then f of n, what do I start with? 5, the ratio, good. And then what do I put after it? F of n minus 1. Alright? I believe there's two more over there, right? The numbers are a little bit ugly. See what you can do with them. Okay? This is the tricks we use. One of them has to be the decimal point. See what I need to deal with. But let's see how far, at least you can get on 72. Give it a good beginning. Thank you. explicit. So f of n equals what? 0.001 times iteration 10 to the what power? Y n minus 1. Good. Okay, and then my recursive is f what? 1 equals. Good. And then f of n equals. Handle it? Okay, so here's what we're going to do next. Your homework's already posted. Okay, so go start working on it. Before you do, I need you to get out your spiral notebook. Okay, and make sure you've labeled your assignment numbers on the top of it. Okay? So go ahead and get that out. Make sure the assignment number is not there. I also will not.